entered your destination.
Oh yeah, been dominating all my danger signs again, have you?
Yeah, I had no doubt either.
Fancy doing some more?
Turn right.
Good news! Because you smashed all those fast travel boards, the Horizon Fast Travel Service have agreed to cover your transport costs. Should make adventuring a lot easier.
When it is safe to do so. You have arrived at your destination. so. Destination. Arrived at your destination. Thank you.
tour guide last week told me about a classic car lying around in a barn somewhere here. Yes, I go on guided tours. What's wrong with that? Be surprised how much you learn.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. Sharp left.
That's the cutoff. A lot of really solid drivers are going home, but you're through. What can I say? Only the fastest survive in street scene.
Arrived at your destination. do so. When it is safe to do so. Recalculating route. In 400 meters, turn right. At your destination. Turn around when it is safe to do so. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
London Electricity here on the home of drum and bass in the UK. Hospital Records, yes. Speaking of it, a feeling.
Why is that, Anthony?
Well, because drivers are tearing up and down the country in competition. And everyone is talking about this genteel classic.
It is safe to do so. Recalculating route. it is safe to do so. In 100 meters, turn left. You have arrived at your destination. destination. Meters, turn sharp left. Turn around when it is safe to do so. You have arrived at your destination. Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 400 meters, you will arrive at your destination. Have arrived at your destination.
Initializing UNSC training protocol 165FD. With the ongoing and evolving threat posed by an increasingly focused Covenant, all frontline UNSC personnel are expected to complete the following training exercise. Upon completion of the training exercise, please submit results to UNSC FleetCom for assessment.
This is Kilo Actual. Cortana, do you read me? I heard you need a pickup.
Cortana to Kilo Actual. Perfect timing. We're all done here and ready for dust-off.
Whoa! A boarding pickup! Sorry, Cortana. I gotta shake these bogeys.
Affirmative, Kilo Actual. I'll scan for a new LZ. Chief, gun it. Get us out of here.
Cortana, what is this place?
I don't know. Looks like a fortification of some kind, but it hasn't been used in centuries.
Is that a Spartan? We're gonna make it home after all!
Okay, new LZ found. We don't have long. This ring is gonna go nuclear in 3 minutes, and we do not want to be here when it does. Marines, I've added coordinates to your nav. Be there for evac in 3 minutes.
Roger that, Cortana. Hoorah!
Look at these ancient dwellings. It almost looks like something lives here.
Just go straight up here. We've got a better chance of avoiding those banshees off-road.
Look out!
Banshees inbound! Try and lose them through those trees!
Alert! Banshees, fast and low. Hey, keep your head down! There's two of us in here now.
Banshee! Save us, Chief!
This is Cortana to all air support units. I'm sending you coordinates for an LZ, requesting immediate evac. Repeat, all air support units to the LZ.
Cortana, I'm getting a green from 3, 4, make that 5 Pelicans. En route to the LZ. You and the Marines had better be there soon. Cortana, I can't follow you through there. I'll see you on the other side.
That's not the most reassuring choice of words. Cave is not a natural formation.
Woo! Echo!
Like this, comms have gone quiet. Kilo Actual, do you read? Kilo Actual. Whoa!
Loud and clear, Cortana.
Good to see you again, pilot. I do not want to reach that LZ without you. Cortana to all units, the LZ is right ahead. We have 30 seconds before the ring superstructure begins to collapse. Good time to leave. Horizon Festival training module complete. Initiating upload of results to UNSC Fleetcom.
Down the field again. You're racing against only hardcore cross-country drivers now, the kind who carry their own tools and sleeping bag. Welcome to round 5 of the cross-country racing series.
With the augmented reality and the halos and the pew, 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 I don't want... put the helmet on myself.
Ooh, a BMW 1M. Great car. Hang on, that's my BMW 1M. Seriously? Not funny. Who gave Stick the keys? I mean, I literally just cleaned it. Now it's gonna smell of onions. Odor Stig.
In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right.
It's a BMW, so of course it's rear-wheel drive. 50-50 weight distribution too. It's a natural-born drifter.
In 100 meters, turn left.
That's the last time we leave Stig unattended. Am I the only one who remembers Budapest? Does 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds, my 1M. Stig's way beyond that now. Look at the smoke! Please leave me some tread for the drive home, Stiggy. Seriously, come on. It's electronically restrained to 155 miles an hour, but it could definitely go quicker. 3-litre straight six, 335 horsepower, two turbos, as much sideways action as you like.
In 100 metres, turn left.
This isn't stressful to watch. Not at all. One of the best BMWs ever made, this. Born to be driven by me. Got to admit, though, Stig does kind of suit it.
At the roundabout, take the second exit. Around when it is safe to do so.
Almost there now. Oh, what a shame. I was really getting into that. Just park it up now, Stig, and mind the curbs. Now, anyone else want to go? No? Don't say I didn't ask. Right. Back to the actual script now, if you don't mind. This is Top Gear's Tractor. It's a tractor, obviously, but with a 5.7 litre Chevy V8 making 500 horsepower. And here comes the Stig again. Farm Stig. Born in a barn, they say, weaned by pigs, can plough a field in under 6 seconds. There's a speed camera on the M68. Rumour has it, it only flashes above 87.2 miles an hour. Our tractor has been officially clocked at 87.2 miles an hour, making it the world's fastest tractor. But I reckon it'll go even faster. Steady on, Stig. Those are 54-inch mud tyres, remember? They get a bit squishy through the corners. Nobody needs to get the harvest in that quickly. Right, here comes the speed camera. Hope they put some film in it. Wow! Have you ever seen anything like it? That's a new tractor speed record and some impressively fast farming. If you want to spread slurry in a hurry, you know what you need. Now, though, it's time to hail a ride in something completely different.
Congratulations! We call that a Forza edition. Custom upgrades you can't get anywhere but here. Big modifications inside and out. I don't even want to think what you'll be able to do with that thing on the road.
I called a cab earlier. Local company, Aisha's Taxis. Excellent service. Got me here in no time. Unsurprising, really. I mean, look at what turned up. Hands down, the quickest cab I've ever been in. Which got me thinking, how fast could this thing actually go? So I had a word with Aisha. Asked if we could borrow her cab for a trip to the seaside. To Bamborough Beach, in fact, where we could stretch the taxi's legs a bit. Although, I might have forgotten to tell her who'd be driving. You've guessed it, the cabbie who'll always get you to your destination very early, but probably won't be anywhere near where you asked to go. Oh, I see, the Stig's warming up the tyres. A good old-fashioned rolling burnout.
You want some spare rubber, huh?
Just goes to show, you can slide almost anything if you know how, even a taxi. Now that's what I call a cab. No clattery diesel engine here. This has a V12 with over 750 horsepower, plus bucket seats. Beaded bucket seats, presumably. From now on, I say all cabs should have wide bodies and flared arches. Think about it. More stability, more speed, more downforce, more room for your terrified passengers. Even has slick tyres for maximum grip on a bone-dry drag strip. So they should be interesting when we hit the beach.
Turn right. Turn left. Turn left. 100 meters, turn left. Turn left. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. Turn left.
Good work from the stick there. I'd say we're nicely warmed up for the next bit. So here we are then. In the old days, daredevils used smooth, sandy beaches like this to see how fast their cars could go. Many early land speed records were set on beaches. Miles of space, nothing to hit. Sounds easy, right? Oh, look at that! Laying some pretty squirmy tracks there, Sticky. That's what happens with 750 horsepower on sand. But that's the challenge here. Go as fast as possible all the way to the top of the beach. The thing is, there's something I haven't told the Stig. Speed record rules say you must do two runs, one in each direction, before the clock runs out. Which means, Stiggy, pulling off the world's swiftest U-turn, which of course is when the handbrake comes in handy. Five-star ride from the Stig there. Minicab, maximum speed. Next time I need a ride to the airport, I know who I'm calling. And all of this off-road action has given me an idea. This is Project EAT. That's EAT for E-Class All-Terrain. It's a modified Merc built by the Top Gear magazine team for finding bears in the woods. Not many bears around here, though. Mostly badgers. Still, there's definitely some terrain. Lots of it. All you need is a good sense of direction. Or not. Here's Stig again, looking lost. Terrified of maps, apparently. Inner compass points directly south. The EAT has a silky smooth V6 diesel. It'll do 155 miles an hour on the road, but where we're going, we won't need roads. First up, it's a trip to the top of Glen Rannoch, by any means necessary, and against the clock, naturally. But don't worry, it has knobbly tyres, and a roof rack for carrying extra knobbly tyres.
In 400 metres, turn left. Turn left. Calculating route.
Well, it is a Mercedes wagon, so it's tough. And if you really want to smash stuff up, there's even a pickaxe in the back. That's a four-wheel drive car on mud tyres, completely sideways. You'd do well in rallying with skills like that. Top draw drifting, I reckon. Who says you need an SUV to go off-road? The EAT has four-wheel drive and air suspension to smooth out lumps and bumps and everyday obstacles. ancient burial mounds, for example.
In 400 meters, turn left. In 400 meters, turn sharp left.
That's some proper hang time. Actual air suspension.
Recalculating route. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn sharp left.
It also has 340 horsepower, more torque than a cruise ship, and gets to 60 miles an hour in just over 5 seconds. To head way over there, to the very top of Arthur's Seat. But first, what goes up must come down.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. Calculating route. In 400 meters, turn left.
It's full of home comforts, the EAT. Charges for almost anything you can charge. Cozy ambient lighting, even a portable espresso machine. Everything the intrepid explorer could ever need.
Route.
All right, all this adventure kit's had a tiny effect on the fuel efficiency. Good job the roof rack holds 2 cans of diesel, and there's another one in the back. Just don't confuse them with your drinking water.
At the roundabout, take the third exit. Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 100 meters, turn left.
To the final stretch now. Just the small matter of getting up Arthur's Seat. The clock's ticking, so better step on it, Stiggy.
In 200 meters, turn left. Turn left.
There we go, the top of Arthur's Seat. No idea who Arthur is, by the way, or why his seat's so big. Nice view, though. Shame there's no time to stick around. Now, I said we'd be driving some British classics, and you don't get more British than a car built in Birmingham designed by a man from Greece. Anyway, here it is, an original Mini Cooper S, an icon of 60s engineering. It was designed for cities, but this is the wide-body one, so we're going to need a bit more room. And I know just the place. Ready, Stig? The Mini is cleverly packaged, capable of carrying four people and their luggage. Hand luggage, presumably. Cooper S was the car to beat on the famous Monte Carlo rally. It pretty much wiped the floor with the competition.
At the roundabout, take the third exit.
The Cooper S was developed by a bloke called John Cooper, who also built F1 cars, so it had real racing pedigree. And it wasn't just Monte Carlo either. The British Saloon Car Championship, the Thousand Lakes Rally, even the Australian Touring Car Championship. Almost any time the Mini turned up, it won.
In 100 metres, turn left. In 400 metres, turn right. Turn right. Turn left.
Here we are! Told you it was spacious. Buddy looks like a sucker in a... We've got everything we need here. An airfield, the original rapid runabout, and the Stig. I'm looking forward to this. Look at that! Laying down some rubber there. Not that it has much to lay. After all, tiny wheels mean tiny tyres. Just showing off. What is it with Minis and shipping containers? They sold nearly 5.5 million Minis, but only this one could fly, apparently. Thank you. Mini punches well above its weight. It's literally unstoppable. Forget rallying. This thing was made for demolition derbies. Tell the Stig we're done now. It's time for a spot of sightseeing. Here we are then, Edinburgh, where it's time for a spot of turbocharged tourism with this, the mighty Porsche GT2 RS. All we need now is our tour guide, McStig, the world's worst Scotsman, allergic to tartan, absolutely petrified of bagpipes, or so I've heard. Right, let's see if we can visit every bell tower in Edinburgh and get back here before they all stop ringing.
In 400 metres, turn left. Turn left.
What a car this is. 3.8-litre flat-six, two turbos, 700 horsepower, all wrapped up in carbon fibre with wings, stripes, holes and vents for snorting in the air.
At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Nippy little thing, isn't it? 0 to 60 takes 2.7 seconds. Just the job for a bit of speedy sightseeing.
In 400 meters, turn right.
It might be street legal, but it's only a pair of fireproof underpants away from being a full-blown racing car.
In 200 metres, turn right. Turn right. Turn right. At the roundabout, take the second exit.
It's a real masterpiece of engineering, this GT2 RS. The wheels are made from magnesium, the exhaust is titanium. It's exotic, savage, and utterly bonkers. I love it!
In 100 meters, turn left. In 200 meters, turn sharp right. Turn sharp right.
It's limited to 211 miles an hour. Any faster and it would need special tyres. But with the stick behind the wheel, who knows? Ooh, inch perfect there. It's wider than a regular 911, this GT2, and about 20 times more terrifying. Basically, the perfect device for nipping in and out of city traffic.
In 200 meters, turn right. At the roundabout, take the first exit.
Into the final stretch now. Note to stick, remember to park properly at the end. And watch out for traffic wardens. Good work. Hard on those carbon ceramic brakes now. They could stop a locomotive dead in its tracks. I told you we'd finish with a fan's favourite, and here it is. No, not the lorry. The thing on the back, under the tarp. You'll love it. But first, we need to move it into position. Thankfully, we have our very own haulage expert, a trucker's trucker. No load too large. Yes, it's Big Rig Stig. Right, now take it easy, Stig. That's some expensive cargo you have back there. Costs as much as a house, and weighs about the same too. Worked out what it is yet? Okay, here are some cryptic clues. It's all-wheel drive, but not four-wheel drive. It's a wagon, but you definitely don't need a horse to pull it.
In 200 meters, turn left. Turn left.
That's 5 tons of flatbed carrying 4 tons on its back. Don't you just hate getting stuck behind a slow, lumbering old... Wait a minute. It's actually accelerating. Up a hill. I guess that's what 900 foot-pounds of torque does for you. That plus trucker Stig. Almost there. Just park it up and we'll whip those covers off. Good job, Big Rig Stig. Suits you, you know. Although, come to think of it, maybe pickups are more your style, especially the one we have in store.
Turn around.
I give you the Mercedes G63 AMG 6x6. It's the ultimate off-roader, a 4-ton, 6-wheel sports utility truck. Basically, a G-Wagon with the back half of a pickup thrown in for free. Up front is a 5.5-litre twin-turbo V8. Usually it's limited to 100 miles an hour, but not this one.
In 100 metres, turn right.
Someone call air traffic control. I'm pretty sure you need a special license to fly one of these. With all of the wheels comes all of the grip. The 6x6 turns mountains into motorways. Is there anything it can't conquer?
In 100 metres, turn left. Turn left.
It makes 536 horsepower and more than 760 newton meters of torque. With that speed limiter removed and with the Stig behind the wheel, it'll do 125 miles an hour with a bit of a run up.
Turn right.
It's tough, the 6x6. After all, it was originally made for the Australian Army. It's basically a tank with heated seats.
In 400 metres, turn left. Turn around when it is safe to do so.
It can wade through a metre of water, this thing. Most cars need full scuba kit at that depth. Ridiculous.
In 400 metres, turn left. Turn left.
Top job there, Stig. Take some roll. No idea what Stig does with a day off. Experimental dance? Goat yoga? Bog snorkeling? Anyway, I've been Chris Harris, and I still am. And this has been the Top Gear Horizon Special. Thanks for coming. Now, let's go see what this Forzathon live thing's all about.
the checkpoint and let's go.
Did we just lose yellow? Coming up on the quarry.
Hey, Blue, thread the needle with me.
Like I'm the only one left.
Turn around when it's...
Make you wavy like, whoa! Surf's up something crazy. Do is what I feels like. That's my real life.
Someone just called me, said there's a classic car abandoned in a barn near here, and then hung up. Weird, right? Does this kind of thing happen often at Horizon?
You have arrived at your destination.
If you found it, I'll be there in a tick. You have?
Yes!
Don't you dare open it without me.
Will you look at that? It's a Spitfire. Not the plane, obviously. It might not look it now, but this car was a masterpiece of British design. Makes you proud.
I'll get someone else to take this back. All this talk of Britain has given me wanderlust.
Destination.
You actually found it? It's actually there. Wow, okay. Be right down.
Oh, it's a Jag. XJ, I think. What's that stuff on the front end? Either this bloke hit a hay bale or he tried to keep chickens in it. Help me get it out of here.
I'll get it back to the garage. See if I can fix it up.
it is safe to do so. In 200 meters, you will arrive at your destination. You have arrived at your destination.
That's a...